coming up on Pierce County News.
Never thought my heart could be softened.
A recovery program gives addicts new life. Tacoma Link celebrates 10 years and flood prevention underway in Orting. Hi, and welcome to Pierce County News. I'm Heather Radall. Leaving a life of drugs and alcohol behind is a milestone for all addicts, but turning your life around forever can be a messy transition. A local program aims to change that, helping addicts take the next step in their recovery. Megan Hutton explains.
In this house, everyone has a story.
From age 13, I was snorting cocaine and drinking every day. You know, been to prison 5 times. Shot in the face, shot in the chest.
I've never ever lived in a place for more than 2 months in my entire life, ever. So I am used to just coming to a place, feeling like an inconvenience.
They are all recovering drug addicts, now clean, living at Gratitude House in Parkland.
Their whole lives have been about tragedy and sadness, and where I want to show them that in recovery, there's joy.
Access to Recovery, known as ATR, is a federal program through Pierce County Community Connections that helps pay for things like safe housing and education.
ATR says, hey, first of all, you're not going to be managing your rent. You're not going to have no money to go spend on drugs. We're going to give you the opportunity to come into a place like this and support you for 5 to 6 months.
That's just enough time to teach recovery's basic life and social skills necessary to keep a job and finish school.
So I went and saw Liz, and she said she was going to help me pay my rent and, like, help me get, like, you know, hygiene stuff. And we sat down and we talked about my goals and, like, what I wanted to do. And the first thing was my GED, and I never thought I'd be able to get that.
We want to be able to take away the burden of financial, financial things for the first little bit of time so that they can concentrate on staying sober, learning life skills, learning how to keep a budget. So when we can open that cocoon, they're ready to go.
Daily chores, a curfew, it's all about accountability to themselves and other people. At the age of 52, Jeffrey has made it through this transition, has an AA, and is working on his bachelor's degree.
As a result of ATR helping me out, I've been able to go to recovery functions to interact a lot more with people in the community. I've even found a part-time job.
They need a stepping stone. And us as taxpayers, this makes me proud to say my tax dollars did something good for somebody. Did they abuse the system? No, because there are things to make sure that they're accountable.
Now that I've been in recovery for a while, I see that helping my fellow man, that's how I get rewarded, and that's what I want to do. I never thought my heart could be softened, but it has.
Megan Hutton, Pierce County News.
Access to Recovery helps about 80 people a month and has served more than 5,000 people since the program began in 2005. To learn more, visit the Community Connections website or call the Resource Center at 253-798-4600. The Pierce County Council voted unanimously to protect shooting ranges from civil and criminal prosecution because of noise complaints. The ordinance exempts ranges from noise complaints between 7 a.m. and 10 p.m.
7 a.m. to 10 p.m. are reasonable hours for the gun ranges to be in operation. And what it does too there, it protects those neighbors from any additional night activities that could happen. So we feel this is a very, very good ordinance.
There are 4 gun ranges in unincorporated Pierce County, in South Hill, Frederickson, Sumner, and Eatonville. The measure does not apply to gun ranges inside city limits.
Shooting sports, enthusiasts, gun safety, law enforcement, our members of the military. There's a lot of good reasons to have it. If you don't have good, safe places to do it, they're going to go somewhere else, and it could be in someone else's backyard, and we don't want that to happen.
This legislation does, as mentioned, provide us noise protection, and there is no lawsuits effective right now. However, there's some lawsuits that are available right now going on over in Kitsap County, and they're just about ready to shut down the Kitsap County Gun Club.
The provisions must be approved by the State Department of Ecology before they can go into effect. The Puyallup City Council is considering a 60-day moratorium on marijuana businesses while it looks at zoning regulations in the city. The council discussed the issue at their August 13th meeting. The moratorium would affect marijuana producers, processors, and retailers.
This is just a temporary restriction that will allow staff to review the state rules that the state is now considering and should be finalized here, hopefully relatively soon, and then how those rules reconcile with our zoning and business licensing regulations.
The city wants to wait until the Washington State Liquor Control Board finalizes its regulations to be sure they don't have conflicting rules.
We need to look at what others are doing. We need to be careful with what has been brought up already here about what the feds versus the state are. This is one that we don't have to leap ahead.
Washington voters approved Initiative 502 last year, which allows people 21 and over to possess and use up to 1 ounce of marijuana. It is still illegal under federal law. Pierce County has already passed a similar moratorium. Tacoma Link Light Rail kicked off its 10th anniversary celebration this week with a contest to win big prizes. We hopped on board to find out why so many people are choosing light rail for their commutes. When Tacoma Link Light Rail took its first ride through downtown Tacoma in 2003, no one could have predicted how quickly it would take off.
Last year in 2012, we had over a million rides on this link, which is phenomenal when you think about it.
The 1.6-mile route runs from the Tacoma Dome to the Theater District with six stops along the way.
It's fast, it's easy. Yeah, it's nice, it's free too. Yep, it's real good.
Some ride the train to get to school or work, and some, like 2-year-old Ainsley, just ride for fun.
She's seen it before, and so, but this is the first one we've actually jumped on.
Plans are in the works to expand the Tacoma Link light rail line by about 2.3 miles from downtown to the medical mile of healthcare facilities off 6th Avenue.
It's a fabulous opportunity for people to be able to use the link for those kinds of services as well.
And an opportunity to celebrate the future of Tacoma Link Light Rail. Sound Transit is celebrating the 10-year anniversary with a contest. Tell them what your favorite Tacoma Link destination is, and you could win big prizes. You can go to Sound Transit's Facebook page or mail in your entry. The contest ends August 31st. For more information, go online to soundtransit.org. There is still quite a lot of work to be done before Tacoma Link Light Rail can expand its route. And joining me today to talk about this is Bruce Gray. He's with Sound Transit. Bruce, where are we in this extension plan for Tacoma Link Light Rail?
We're in the very early environmental stages where we're looking at potential impacts from expanding the line and trying to determine where it's going to go.
Do we know a basic route of where this will go and who it will serve?
We know the general corridor. Over the past several years, we've been looking at dozens of alternatives. What we've settled on, based on the feedback we've heard from people in Tacoma and the city, is an alignment that'll generally go north, serve the Stadium District, Hospital Mile, and the Hilltop neighborhood.
Okay, and what about funding? How do you plan on funding this extension?
The Sound Transit 2 package was approved by voters in 2008. It stipulated a $150 million budget to expand Tacoma Link. And included in that is a $50 million commitment from Sound Transit. We're going to be going for another $50 million in federal grants. To be determined is the final $50 million that would come from local sources, whether that's a public-private partnership. That's what's being worked out today, and that's what we're talking to the City of Tacoma about.
And I know that people who are just hearing about this expansion, especially who use the Link Light Rail, are so excited to hear about it. Maybe let's talk about the timeline and then how people can get involved.
No, it's going to be a great opportunity to connect the existing Tacoma Link line, Tacoma Dome Station, and the trains and buses and all that that serves. We'll be back in October talking to the public about specific alignments, specific routes on streets and station locations, and hear what the public has to say about that, which ones might work and which ones are off the table. From there, we move ahead into more formal environmental work. Big picture, start construction in 2017, open in 2020, 2021.
All right, well, something to look forward to. Thanks so much for coming in today.
Thank you.
Pierce Transit has become the first in the nation to use landfills to help fuel buses. This summer, Pierce Transit started using renewable compressed natural gas in its buses.
The renewable gas that we're now using is coming from a landfill, whereas regular natural gas, which we compress to CNG, comes out of the ground.
The gas, which comes from local landfills, is more environmentally friendly, but it also costs about 50 cents a gallon.
It just seems logical to work with our partners in the region to make sure that we're tapping the renewable natural gas that is emerging. This is a happy step. We're glad to lead the way on that.
Pierce Transit has a long history of sustainable practices. It was one of the first agencies to switch to compressed natural gas in 1986. The county is doing some preventative work this summer before the heavy rain season. Construction began this month along the Puyallup River and will eventually protect 2 miles of Orville Road near Orting. Since the flood of 1996, the Puyallup River has been migrating closer to Orville Road, a main road to South Pierce County. Surface Water Management is installing 6 log jams made up of trees, brush, and 8-ton concrete dolos.
Rather than try to levee the river and straighten the river out and armor the banks like what we've done in the past, is to allow the river to move around naturally like it wants to. So braid around, migrate around, and these structures allow the river to do that, create the kind of braided network that habitat would like to see, but at the same time slow the river down enough to decrease the erosive forces of the river and thereby protect the road.
The project will reduce flood risk along Orville Road, protect homes and businesses, and enhance salmon habitat along the Puyallup River. This is the first phase of a multi-phase project. It's expected to wrap up in late September. Coming up next, see how neighbors are feeding the community without lifting a finger, and how you can do it too. We're back in just 60 seconds.
Live with a human for a while and you get to know a few things. Like, I know she's actually not a morning person. I know she does strange tricks for no treats. I know that water makes her howl like crazy. I even know how the floor stays so clean. She's quick. But the one thing I will never for the life of me know is how she gets so tiny and inside that box. Natalie, how do you get so tiny?
Now we can make it better now. Come on, can we do it?
Yeah, you know that we can.
We'll rope it up,
cause we know how to jump.
We'll roll it out, roll it
cause
out.
We know how to skate.
We'll cut it down,
cause
cut it down.
We know what to eat.
We'll swap it out.
We eat healthy stuff.
Can we do it?
Yeah, you know that we can.
Can we do it?
Just moving a little and eating better every day can help make you and your child healthier. Search We Can to find doable tips and activities that you can use every day.
If you've grown more fruit or vegetables than you can handle this summer, don't let that produce go to waste. There's a place in Pierce County that can put it to use. Volunteers from the Pierce County Gleaning Project are out in full force picking fruit off trees and harvesting gardens.
We bring volunteers out to fruit trees and local farms and harvest that excess and then bring it back and share it with food banks and hot meal sites across the county.
We caught up with this group picking plums at a house in Lakewood. The homeowner made one phone call. This group arrived to pick the fruit and they delivered it to the nearest food bank. 15,000 pounds of fruit were picked just in July. If you want to help, there are some perks for volunteering.
So if you're looking to can this season or just preserve food for the long term, volunteers for our fruit tree harvest get to take up to 50% of the fruit home.
Last year, the group harvested more than 50,000 pounds of food that would have gone to waste. To have this group come to your home or sign up to volunteer, go to piercecountygleaningproject.org. Up next, Mark Richards gets us into the movies for free. But first, here's some dates for your calendar. If you love the water, don't miss Maritime Days coming up in Tacoma. There will be free boat rides, a kid zone, music, and food. The festival happens on the Theophos Waterway on Saturday, August 24th and Sunday, August 25th from 10 until 5. Admission is free. For more information, go to maritimefest.org. If you're looking for a fun family event and great dinner, head to the Hudson Bay Day Salmon Barbecue in DuPont. It happens on Sunday, August 25th from noon until 4 at the DuPont Fire Department Bay on Civic Drive. Enjoy music, guided tours, great food, and lots of fun activities for the kids. For more information, go to the City of DuPont's website. This week, Mark Richards has his front row seat reserved. Hi, Mark.
Hi, Heather. Why go to the theaters when you can catch a free show at one of the most beautiful locations in Pierce County? This is your last chance this summer to enjoy a free movie at Chambers Creek Regional Park. On Saturday, August 24th, we will be playing Disney's Oz the Great and Powerful. The movie is rated PG-13, so bring the whole family in a large blanket out to this awesome event. Pre-movie entertainment and games will start at 7 p.m. and the movie will start at dusk. We are now registering for fall Learn to Skate classes. You may sign up online or in person at Sprinker for ice skating and learn to play hockey classes. There's no better time than now to teach your kids how to ice skate. Sprinker's newly renovated facility offers a great environment for both skaters and spectators. So don't miss your chance to skate through the fall. Register for ice skating classes today. Only 7 more hours until dusk. I can't wait for this movie to start. I'm Mark Richards for Pierce County News. Back to you, Heather.
Thanks, Mark. You can see Pierce County from here on PCTV. We have the original programming you can't find anywhere else. You can watch Pierce County News online anytime or tell us about a story idea you have for our newscast. Just go to our website at piercecountytv.org. I'm Heather Radel. Thanks for watching Pierce County News.